Now, you see we have a parseJSON function that takes a string of JSON in, and then we're going to parse it using the JSON.parse method that is included and accessible in just about any modern browser. JSON.parse takes this string, weapon.jsonin, and will return a JavaScript object representing the JSON that it's parsed. Now, once we've done that, what I want you to do is grab a specific piece of data from that JSON. Let's say you want to grab data from the JavaScript object returned from JSON.parse. And let's say you put that JavaScript object into the variable parsed. Now, in order to grab the chain gun sub-object, then you would simply say parsed frames chaingun.png like so, and then put it in the variable chain gun, let's say. Now let's take a look up above at the structure. What that would do is it would walk down first into frames and then into chain gun, and what would be stored in the chain gun variable would then be this entire structure. So everything inside of chaingun.png. Now what I would like you to do is grab the X data field inside sprite source size of chaingunimpact.png and go ahead and print that out to the console. Chaingunimpact.png isn't up in our example JSON, but the JSON that we'll be running through this function does have it.